Hi, here we are now looking into item conversion. What do you mean by conversion? We are moving the legacy data into Oracle Base Tables, Oracle eBusiness Suite. For that, we have to follow one process. So the process is, we will get the legacy data that we are moving into the staging table through SQL loader. Further, we are writing one PLSQL package. Data will be moved into the interface table. Finally, we will running the standard concurrent program so that the data will be moved into the base table. Once if the data is moved into the base table, our conversion process is finished. So now for this, what we require? We require SQL loader, and we have to write package, and we require a standard concurrent program and also file. So in this base tables, this is seeded base table MTL system items B, the interface table MTL system items interface, the staging table, this is a custom table created by the user, this is R1 item staging. So we are using the standard concurrent program import items. Let us look into the practical approach. So the first and foremost thing is, we have to get the legacy information, legacy data required. So this is what legacy data. So in this, I have created 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 records. So these 7 records, so which is invalid, which is valid, everything it will be filtered. The valid record will be successfully inserting, and invalid records will be filtered. So we are taking this legacy data now. So the next process is, we are moving this legacy data into the server. So I'm moving it to the server. Better to take text transfer settings as to all now. So now the file is moved into the server. So now our next responsibility is move into the Oracle eBusiness Suite. In this eBusiness Suite, go to system administrator, concurrent, program, executable. So in this executable, create executable file name. This already I have created SQL executable, execution method as SQL star loader. Next, after that, create a concurrent program. Create a concurrent program and take in the concurrent program. Concurrent program name as XXREM ITM skill loader program. So again, after creation of this concurrent program, again create one procedural concurrent program in order to call three procedures. Let us look into the procedures package. So this is what we created a package. In this, we have created package and package body. So we have created the map procedure, do cur procedure, arg underscore cur procedure, and item underscore cur. Sorry, these are the cursors. It's a validate procedure, map procedure, And load procedure and call prod procedure. So whenever if you run this call prod procedure, automatically the three procedures will be called. So that's why we have created a concurrent program here, call procedure. So in this, in executable method, we'll give package name dot procedure name. The package name is what here? The package name is r underscore item pack dot call prod in that executable file name. So once, whenever if you write that one, automatically these three procedure will be called. Okay, so again, what status check also we create a concurrent program. In the status check, so which are the validated records that will be called? Validated records will be called. So the final thing is error report. So this report only we are giving to the customer, giving to the client. So the next thing is next thing is, so we have to run this package now. So I'm running this package, run underscore test dot sql. See, package created, package body created. Okay, use commit. Now run this concurrent programs. So individually I won't run this concurrent programs. I'm taking one request set. In that request set, all concurrent programs are mentioned. Even I'm taking standard concurrent program as well. Now run this concurrent program. It will take some time to complete. Yes, completed is normal. So now go to Toad. To Toad query select out from normal item state. See, we kept it as empty, right? Which is a mandatory column missing. It's an error message. So it is a way which is called a correct record. Valid record it is. So it is invalid organization, is a valid record. The two records are inserted into the table. Which table inserted? Base table, empty system, items, B. Check whether this table is inserted or not in the front end. Item, master item, F11, controller. Yes, table has been created. Okay, so record has been created into this empty system items B. Once if it is created in front end, we can view this data. So our import process is finished, and also we have to send the error report to the client. For that, what is our responsibility? So I will show you the error report to you. So this is what error report. Click on your output. So this is what error report. This error report should get sent to the client. So total number of records are 7, mandatory column is missing 1, duplicate records 0, validate records are 2, validated error records 4. So total 2 records are successfully inserted. Okay. So this is about our conversion process. Thank you.